discuss about the concept of inheritance in Java. So inheritance in Java. Inheritance is one of the important feature of the Java programming language. So basically inheritance means what? Inheritance nothing but it's one of the mechanism which is used to acquire the properties of from one class to another class. Inheritance generally it is a mechanism. Inheritance is a mechanism which is used to inheritance is a mechanism which is used to acquire the properties of from one class to another class. This is nothing but inheritance definition. What is the meaning of it? Inheritance is basically mechanism which is used to acquire the properties of from one class to another class. What are the properties? So if you consider a class, class is basically a collection of objects, we can see that. Class is a collection of objects. On a computer, that is object, that is formed by the object. Okay. So properties representing here we will get two things, major which are nothing but the fields of the class, of members of the class, and the second thing is the methods. Methods of the class. Properties representing two things only, fields and methods. Fields and methods, if you consider any class, it contains two properties only, fields and methods. Data members, number functions, we can say that. Variables, functions, we can say that. So like that. So which are nothing but properties, okay? So here we are going to use one of the mechanism called inheritance. So this inheritance, it can provide, it can give the chapter, it is going to provide a mechanism that will be applied to acquire the properties of from one class to another class. Properties represent the fields as well as the methods. Okay. So what is the advantage of the inheritance? Inheritance is majorly we are going to use, we are going to achieve reusability concept. Inheritance that we can apply, to achieve one of the important properties called reusability. And the second one is the extensibility. We can extend the classes. Okay. So to achieve these two things only, we are going to use the inheritance concept only. Okay, to achieve these two properties, reusability as well as extensibility. Okay, for example, generally a child can use the properties of parents. Suppose a parent is a building owner. And then automatically the child is also owner of the same building because child can use the properties of their parents. Okay, the same concept here we are going to apply. Okay, in between the classes. Okay, so here one class can acquire the properties of another class. Representing what? One class is going to use the properties of another class. It means that a class can acquire the properties of another class, which is fields and methods. One class can use the properties of another class. Okay, so this kind of mechanism is called inheritance. So the main thing is inheritance concept that we are going to use to achieve these two things only, reusability as well as extensibility. That is the advantage. General example is something that a child can use the properties of parent class. Okay, for example, I'm going to draw one thing. We are discussing about classes only, so I have taken one of the class called A here. And second class I am taking here, the class name is, suppose it is B. Now we are applying inheritance concept, okay. So this inheritance concept representing what? A class can acquire the property from one class to another class. So here, there are two classes are available, like class A and class B here, okay. So here, once you look at the diagram, the class B can acquire the properties of class A. So here, class A having fields, as well as the methods. Okay, similarly, class B also having fields as well as the methods. These are the properties only. These are all the properties only. So here class B can acquire the properties of class A. So automatically, so whatever contents available on class A, whatever the fields used by the class A, whatever the methods used by the class A, which can acquire by the class B. Okay, and class B also may contain fields and methods. That is different thing. But here the proper, here the concept is the class B can acquire the properties of this class A. Okay, so that is the point only here. And next, there are two things that are available here. This is, here one class is available, here another class is available. The name, the classes contain some different names here. So here I can say that the class A can be called as a base class. Okay, base class. And class B can be called as a derived class. Okay, in general, inheritance means generating a new class from the old class. We can say that. That definition also we can consider, generating a new class from the old class. That is also we can consider. Here, the old class can be called as a base class, and the new class can be called as a derived class. Here, the class B can acquire the properties of class A. Here, the class A becomes parent, class B becomes children. Okay, so this parent class can be called as a base class, and we can say that a super class also we can say that. Sometimes we can use this word super class, and derived class also we can call it as a subclass. Okay, like that many synonyms are there for a class. We can say that this is a basic base class, this is a derived class, a super class, a subclass. Here derived class can acquire the properties of the base class. This is okay, we are applying mechanism, that is okay. Where we are going to utilize these things? Suppose whenever you are developing a big projects, whenever you go to the industry side, one project I want to develop, one particular project I want to develop. Okay, so for this project I require 3 people. For example, 3 people I require, 1, 2, 3. So as a team manager, I am dividing this the task into these 3 people. So I am assigning the first person, please develop 100 lines of code. Okay, for this project, for one module. Second person, need to develop 200 lines of code to develop the project, one another module. Third person, I am assigning 300 lines of code to develop the project, which is a third module. First module, second module, third module. Whenever we are collaborating everything, then only the project is going to be finished. Okay, fine. Suppose comes to the first person, he has developed 100 lines of code, that is okay. Whenever come to the second person need to develop 200 lines of code. But the second person thinks smartly means this 200 lines of code is I want to develop, okay fine, I can develop it. But this in the 200 lines of code, any 50 lines or 100 lines are available with the first person or not, is going to verify. The same kind of code sometimes we are going to use it. The same kind of methods sometimes we are going to use it in our programming side. Suppose the 100 lines of code is already available in the first module, then the second person is going to apply inheritance concept and he can use this 100 lines of code. Then the remaining 100 lines of code he has to learn. Here what we are applying, we just use the concept of inheritance, and we are achieving the reusability concept. Okay, it means that the second person work button will be reduced. Okay, and time is also not wasted. That is the advantage of the inheritance concept. Similarly, suppose the third person 300 lines of code he need to develop. Suppose the same lines of code is available in between 1 and 2, for example. 1 and 2, whatever the lines of code they are used, the same lines are available in this module also. Then the third person is automatically applying inheritance concept, and he can use these 100 lines of code for his module. Then he is going to complete his task immediately. So he do not worry about his code. Automatically he can use this and he can complete his work. Finally, the project automatically completed. Like that, the use of the concept can be applied in the real-time environments. That is the advantage. Okay, we need to think about the programming development. Okay, whatever the methods, oldest methods are available, oldest classes are already available, we are going to reuse it. Just applying the concept to call inheritance. Okay, so this is nothing but inheritance introduction. Okay, so inheritance basically it's a mechanism which is used to acquire the properties of common class to another class. Properties are nothing but every class contain two things only, fields and methods. Okay, so generating a new class from the old class, we can say that, and the new class can acquire the properties of the old class. For example, a child can use the properties of a parent. Okay, suppose a parent is a Punarapti mandiri. Then Chinese also mandiri same way. Okay, whenever we are applying this concept. Okay, so that is a real time development. That is a real time development here. So that there are two classes available here. For example, in this diagram, class A and class B. Here, class B is a children class, class A is a parent class. So class B can have the properties of class A. This can be called as an inheritance concept. Okay, real time development is a simple example. And coming to there are types of inheritance also available. There are, we have five types of inheritances we are having. Okay. Which are nothing but single inheritance, multi-level inheritance, multiple inheritance, single inheritance, multi-level inheritance, multiple inheritance, hierarchical inheritance. Last one is a hybrid inheritance. Five types of inheritances we are having. The same concept we are going to apply. Same thing. Acquiring the properties from one class to another class in five different ways we can say that. Okay. So there are five types of inheritances are available. Single, multi-level, multiple, hierarchical, and hybrid. Single nothing but this is a simple diagram. This is the same diagram we are going to apply. There is a single base class. There will be a single base class as well as a single derived class. As well as a single derived class. So here the class B anchor the properties of the class A. So it is simple diagram. There will be a single base class, there will be a single derived class, then it represents the one single inheritance. So class B anchor the properties of class A. This is nothing but a single inheritance. A single inheritance. Second one is about the multi-level inheritance. Multi-level inheritance means there is a parent class. There is a parent class and there is a child class. There is a parent class, there is a child class. In between them, many intermediate classes will be available. Many intermediate classes will be available here. Okay. For example, if you look at the diagram, there are three classes available, like class A, class B, class C. Here class A is a parent, class B is a children. In between these two classes, class A is a parent, class B is a children. And coming here, class B is a parent, class C is a children. Then what about the relationship between class A and class C? Class A grandparent is class A and here is a grandchild. Okay. So here we are having a single base class, we are having a single children class. In between the many intermediate base classes are available. Okay. Here class B can acquire the properties of class A. Class B can acquire the properties of class A. And class C can acquire the properties of class B as well as class A. So here class A and class C can use the properties of both classes B and A. And class A, class A is a base, main base class, class B is an intermediate base class, C is a children class. Okay, utilizing our property, class B can utilize only the properties of class A. Class C can utilize the properties of only class B. So this can be called as a multi-level inheritance. And we can include many levels, we can develop many levels. We can include class C. I'm going to explain this class. I'm going to use class B here. So here B and C are the intermediate base classes, and here B is a children class, and class A is a grandparent. Okay, like that, many intermediate base classes can be included. This can be called as a multi-level inheritance. Okay. Next one is a multiple inheritance. Multiple inheritance means too many base classes. Too many base classes. For example, here class A and I'm representing class B here, okay, and class C. Too many base classes, only one child class, only one child class. This can be called as a multiple inheritance. Too many base classes and one child class, for example. That is representing what? Multiple inheritance. So here class A can acquire the properties of both class A as well as a class B. Here class A, class B are the base classes, class C is a derived class. This is called multiple inheritance. Okay. Next one is a hierarchical inheritance. Hierarchical inheritance means what? Here, hierarchical inheritance means one class, one base class. Many children classes like class B,
class A.
Here, the class A can acquire the properties of class A and class A can acquire the properties of class B. Okay, so this is nothing but hierarchical representation. Last one is the hybrid class. Hybrid class is nothing but any two combinations of inheritance. Any two combination of inheritance we can apply, or more than two also we can apply, then that representing what? Hybrid inheritance. For example, class A here. We are applying here B as well as C, and C is also representing like this. Here you can say that we are combining two kinds of inheritance, hierarchical as well as a multiple. Then this can be called as a hybrid inheritance. Okay, so this is nothing but introduction of the inheritance concept as well as types of inheritances. Okay, so this is about the introduction to inheritance as well as types of the inheritance concept.